turn me up a little bit, turn me up a little bit, turn me up a little bit.
It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Ayy, it's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Ayy, we in this. We in this. Ayy, we in this. Ayy, we in this. Ayy, it's the Buck Bandit Podcast.
Yeah, 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 you know what it is. We back here once again, live on another episode of Buck Bandit Podcast. Episode 32.
What it do?
Yeah. You already know. We back another hot week, another great episode we got on our hands, you know what I mean?
Yes, sir. You already know.
You know what I mean? Looking mighty fresh, my man. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, thank you, my brother. You looking fresh too, you know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
Young fresh to death, you know what I mean?
Yeah, fresh and funky. You know what I mean? We in this bitch.
Yes,
but you
sir.
Know, appreciate that. You know what I mean? We gonna get into this hot show because we've been waiting all week to get this to y'all. You know what I'm saying? You already know what it is, man. Oh, yeah. I ain't even introduced herself. I'm the host, Buck Bandit Reno.
Your boy, Buck Bandit P. You know what I'm saying?
And let's get into this show, man, because there's a lot of things. You see, we excited, man. We got some shit to talk about. We got some shit to get into, man.
Yes, sir. You know what I mean? As usual.
So what's the first thing we getting into today, man?
And we getting in the bum, Ben Simmons.
Oh, didn't see you sitting there. What you doing there, man? What you doing here? I know why you here. You want studio time. Well, lucky you. We down here during the corona times, and as long as you got your mask and disinfect it, come on down, man. $40 an hour, $100 for 3 hours, $180 for 5 hours, man. Management deals, monthly deals, whatever you need. Come on down to Buck Bandit Studio, man. Now get out of here, man. Get out of here before I catch that rona.
Benson, we're
gonna, God.
We gonna talk about Ben Simmons.
What you wanna talk about?
We talk about, we need to give him up for Dame Dollar. That's what we need.
Listen,
we need
first of
fucking
all,
Dame Dollar.
Ben Simmons, first of all, you fuck yourself over, nigga. Because all we do is ask you to fucking shoot, my nigga. Shoot. We don't care if you miss
fucking
it.
Ball.
We don't care. Just shoot. And instead of you shooting, nigga, you want to leave town, man. Fuck out of here, man.
He said he want to leave town. On the first thing smoking. That's that Australian shit. I don't know what the fuck is up with boy.
I don't know what's up, you know what?
Tripping.
Fuck you, nigga. Leave then, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Fuck out of here,
dog. How you be mad at the fans want you to shoot the ball? Like, that's some hoe ass shit.
That's
like
backwards, my nigga. That's
nigga
backwards.
Like, man, fuck this, man. I just want to leave, man. These niggas
I just want to leave, mate. He's made it.
All right, mate.
You know what I'm saying? Fuck out of here, bro. Like, all you had to do was just work on your shot, man. You hit all them motherfucking three-pointers, middies, fadeaway jumpers in practice and get in the game and then fucking pass up layups and shit, man.
There was no way in the hell the Sixers were supposed to lose to the Hawks last year. No way in hell.
Man, I don't even
want
to get back to that,
supposed to fucking lose to the Hawks, bro. Everybody who had any type of basketball intelligence was like, oh, yeah, the Sixers and the Bucks in the Eastern Conference, right? Like, it was already set. Niggas already knew what it was.
Nah,
and Ben Simmons shot three
ben
fucking
said,
shots.
Nah, I'm
like,
what? Good day, mate. Gave him all the buckets.
Nigga, like, how you at the rim and you fucking not even dunking, attempting layups? Like, you, like, the fix must have been in. He must have betted on the Hawks or something.
I don't know what he did, man,
that's the only thing I could think
you
of.
You got the nerve to say you want a trade request and you ain't been treated right, nigga. You ain't treat us right, motherfucker. We've been going 10 years with this motherfucking process bullshit.
Trust in the process.
Trust in the motherfucking process. And they just gave Embiid the motherfucking nickname because you ain't want to fucking get better.
Real shit.
So we couldn't say it's both of y'all we trust in. It's Embiid we trust in. Fuck
right.
You, nigga.
Right. And B,
and you
want to
fucking leave, nigga.
Yeah, that's crazy. That nigga's mad as shit. Well,
wherever you go, they're going to tell you
to
shoot
too. I was just about
to
say the same.
Where the fuck you want to go? And they're going to say, yo, Ben, what are you doing, dog?
I was just about to say
the same shit. You're a 6'10 point guard. Shoot.
No matter where he go, they can be like, yo, bro, you come over here, you going to have to shoot the fucking basketball. I don't give a fuck what kind of defense you play. I don't give a fuck how good you at passing the ball and the fast
break. So in that case, what's the point of leaving?
Yeah, like,
and
that's
this,
crazy.
You know what I'm saying? All you literally got to do is go in there and just shoot the ball.
Yeah.
If you miss it, nobody even be mad, bro. It's just open in the court.
Right.
But you just want to bitch up on some, I don't know, some Australian shit and fucking just leave.
Because
the fans is mad because we understand your potential and you ain't living up nowhere near close to it.
Yeah. You tried to defend him for a minute.
I was defending this nigga for
years. That's why I can't even be mad at you. Like, you tried to defend this nigga. You like, no, but after that last season, no, it ain't no. It
how
ain't
many
no rap,
videos
dog.
I brought to you to this ain't nigga no shooting rap, jumpers cause. For how many years?
Yeah, that.
How many
nigga.
We seen taking an actual yeah. motherfucking game?
Right. I thought he was gonna actually be shooting how he started off this year, but no, he got right back into regular form and was bitching, straight bitching.
So I guess it is what it is, man. Like, you wanna leave, then go. Nigga,
peace
call
out,
motherfucking
bro.
Tyrone, motherfucking. Tell him to come and help you get your shit. We don't give a fuck here in Philly, nigga. Yeah. You ain't do shit.
Peace
like,
the fuck out, bro.
You know what I mean? At least come back for like a couple games and show that you're not as much of a bitch so we can trade you for
so
Dame.
He's not as much as a bitch, right?
So we can trade you for
don't
Dame.
Nobody even probably wants you.
Dame
your
perfect
ass.
For Philly, bro.
Yeah, we had Dame Dollar here. Yeah, we definitely have been chipped last year. You tripping. But yeah, that's, man. It's a bad joint, Ben. I ain't even got no more words for you, dog. Peace out, holla at you. Go back to Australia, dog.
No, we not even going to holla at you, nigga. Just peace out, nigga, peace.
We not even
going
to holla at you, nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
Deuces, dog. Damn. Yeah, we can...
How the fuck you trash and you requesting a trade?
Like, niggas let you down. What the fuck?
Motherfuckers gave you the keys to the motherfucking Cadillac and you crashed it.
Right.
And now you...
And you mad at
you
the nigga who gave you the keys.
Yeah, like, what?
You shouldn't have gave me the keys in the first place. Nigga, what?
You know what I do. You know what... Don't give me no gun. You know what I'm going to do.
Oh, man. Yeah, fuck that, man. Simmons...
Which lead us to this, right? Because that shit almost put you in a fighting mood.
Yeah,
like, you just want to fuck something up. You know what I'm saying? Kind of like T.O. want to do McNabb. You know what I'm saying?
Buck Bandit P here to tell y'all once again, fresh buck gear is in. So make sure y'all copping up on that buck gear. We got it from the adult sizes all the way down to the kids sizes. Shirts, hoodies, all kind of flavors, custom colors, whatever you need. Just make sure y'all get at us. You hear the phone is popping right now for this new buck gear. So make sure y'all get at us. Follow us on the Instagram at Buck Bandit Clothing, or you can follow us on Twitter at Buck Clothing, or hit us up on that email. That's buckbanditclothing@gmail.com. You already know what it is. Let's get it. To your fuck McNabb up.
Oh, yo, listen. He said he'll do a celebrity boxing match, whatever. But if it was his first pick, it gotta be McNabb. And he said he's knocking him the fuck out.
Oh yeah.
To
and then I had one guy that's like, yo, this is gonna be funny. It's like, if you had to fight him, who would you want to fight? I said Donovan McNabb. And I'm dead serious. Shannon, I'll knock him out.
I'm gonna knock McNabb. McNabb don't want no smoke with T.O. I'll tell you that right now.
McNabb been talking so much shit, and it's like
so much
he not
shit.
Even to me. He not even one of our best quarterbacks we ever had.
Yeah,
like, people always say, yeah, he took us there. But honestly,
I'm taking Nick.
That's Andy Reid coaching, cuz. Well, you gotta take Nick Foles, nigga. You got us a Super Bowl.
Yeah, McNabb, man. I don't understand how he get the right to talk shit. Like, who fucking gave him the... Yeah, McNabb, you can talk some shit. Like, nigga, you ain't really do shit in the... Like, man, he had a whole lot
and
more...
And he threw up like Willie Beaman in the Super Bowl without the same results, though.
You never live that down, though. You threw up in the Super Bowl on the winning drive? Oh, my
with
God.
Timeouts.
With timeouts. With T.O.? Oh, bro. Like, you
with T.O., with timeouts, yeah. T.O. had a fucking bolt in his ankle. Still had
still was
like
balling.
180 receiving
yards.
Still
was balling. Like, yeah, I don't know, man. Like, yeah, but I would definitely love to see that. That's a celebrity boxing match I would definitely love to see for real, because McNabb would get his ass whooped.
But I don't know. McNabb, you know, I'm just like, no. I was about to try to lie and play devil's advocate, but I can't even do that. Like,
you can't, man. McNabb.
Yo, T.O. told him, nigga, I knocked that chunky suit from 2004 out his ass.
So you literally tried to knock the man out?
Clean out. I knocked chunky suit from him. From 2004. Trust me.
I said, oh, shit.
CEO was talking spicy.
Oh, yeah. Yo, he don't like him. He don't like him. You can tell.
Yeah, he definitely
He broke
don't
down
like
the whole story of how McNabb, you know what I'm saying?
Say, I heard McNabb got him kicked off the team or some shit. Like, he was
basically,
talking,
you know what I'm saying? He said it all started in the huddle where he was open on the play. And he came back. He was like, yo, I was wide open. What happened? And McNabb was like, nigga, shut the fuck up.
That's fucked up.
That's how it happened. He said he ain't say nothing. He let it roll because he ain't want to show him up in the huddle.
Right.
And he got in the locker room and everybody left and he stepped to him and was like, yo, don't ever let that shit happen again, cuz.
Don't you ever come around here again, nigga. Okay. Straight up. Yeah.
So after that, you know what I mean? He basically said it was turmoil. Like, contract time came up and he ain't speak
McNabb
up.
McNabb ain't vouch for him and all that. Yeah, knowing he was.
And I know he was mad either. Too because we never shout McNabb when he come out, but when T.O. came, we was like,
niggas
T.O.
Was hyping shit,
T.O. T.O. T.O.
That's because McNabb always bitching.
No, it's just T.O. was a great player.
Right.
McNabb wasn't.
Exactly. And that's basically
it's not
what
no
it was.
Deeper than that.
That's
like,
basically what it was. T.O. is definitely a better caliber player than McNabb was. That's,
you know what
facts.
I'm saying?
Like you said,
he probably
McNabb
top
wasn't...
three best receivers all time.
Oh, yeah, guaranteed. They snubbed him on the fucking Hall of Fame joint. He should have definitely got in first ballot.
Because of, off the field. Because
off the field, but that shit don't
He ain't
matter.
Really do no dumb shit off the field. Right. Like, what, work out in front of the cameras on his own property?
Because he was, I guess, braggadocious. And, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's
he,
what it was.
He was confident and made other motherfuckers feel small.
And
like,
the celebrations and all that shit. Like, that shit used to make that team mad.
Right.
We love that shit, though,
numbers.
As the audience.
Hell yeah, we love that shit.
He pulled
nigga.
The popcorn. He fucking took the marker out of his shoe and signed the motherfucking football. He ran to the.
T.O. had some of the best joints.
He ran to the fucking Cowboys star.
Yo, T.O. had some of the best. Celebration, I think all that shit stemmed from
he the best celebrator of all time football, probably.
That's a fact. That's a fact. That's definitely a
before
fact.
Him, the only person you probably could say was like Deion.
But
there's a lot of other niggas that dance when they score, but not rememberable with their own
like
signature T.O. shit.
Yeah, not
like
T.O.
got his own signature like celebration,
But yeah, I definitely pay to see him whoop Donovan.
Celebration
McNabb's.
Package.
I definitely.
I'll pay for that. You know what I'm saying? I won't, but I would.
Right.
If I was the type to pay for fights.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I definitely would buy. I would buy that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just because I don't like McNabb. Like, you know,
I don't like him either because he always talking shit.
And before that, I just didn't like him as a quarterback. I just feel like every time we had a chance,
right?
I don't know him as a person. But as a quarterback, I just felt like he was getting too many commercials for the way he was playing.
Right.
Like, every time it was a short pass, he would throw that nigga's feet. Long pass.
That was his favorite
That was his favorite joint.
The shoestring pass.
Yeah,
nigga. What the fuck?
You know what I mean? If you could catch with your toes, if you have a monkey
if you
or
have
some
a gorilla.
Shit, yeah, nigga, then he your favorite quarterback. Because he throwing it where nobody else can get it but you, nigga. Motherfucker.
Straight up.
Ain't nobody get it but you.
That nigga, man.
But yeah, I mostly ain't like him because of that. I don't know him personally.
Yeah.
But then when I see him talking, that made me not like him more.
Right,
so
as
like,
an announcer.
There was a reason why I don't like you, nigga. This is like
I knew it was a reason I ain't like him in chess.
Yeah.
Straight up. But yeah. McNabb, it's a bad job, bruh. You should have vouched for T.O. You should have gave him the fucking ball. We would have two chips by now. We really could talk our shit.
Well, actually, more than that, because T.O. probably would have stayed. Yeah. And we probably would have had a chance
probably
to run it back.
Probably had a chance to run that shit back.
You know what I mean? But at the same time, you know what I mean? If he didn't throw up and the play went, who's to say he wouldn't have threw it at a nigga feet? You know what I'm saying? So we in a lose-lose anyway.
Real shit, ain't no way you could win.
You know what I'm saying?
No way we could win with
we
that
in a lose-lose anyway. You know what I'm saying? But I still can't believe he told T.O., nigga, shut the fuck up. Yo, what happened? Nigga,
Yo, that's fucking hilarious. I ain't know that.
Yeah, that's where it started. Man, McNabb thought he was mad, man.
Oh, man.
But let's...
Skirt.
What you want to talk about next?
We talking about versus shit, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. We want to talk about Ja Rule versus Fat Joe.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, Versus. Now, this ain't the Verses I wanted to see for real.
Who you wanted to
see? We all know the Verses we wanted to see.
Who you wanted to see?
Ja Rule versus 50. That's what we all wanted to see.
Yo, but I'll say this. Ja Rule might have fucked around and beat 50 in a battle, bro, in a Versus battle. I don't know about that. I can say that, bro.
You got to pick 20 songs. And 50 going to play some block shit.
Long
and
Ja Rule going to come in like,
baby.
Oh, he definitely going to play that joint. Okay. Yeah, you can guarantee. He going to play like 4 or 5 joints with Ashanti from the rip. Yeah. You already know.
No, he got to switch up his playlist, nigga. So then what he going to come out with? Holla, holla. Everybody, they get dollars.
That was that shit, though. I ain't going to lie.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah,
no, that ain't gonna hold.
But
up.
Some of his best songs got Fat Joe on it, so I don't know how that's gonna work out. Maybe they end off the whole set with New York or something like that. But
yeah, they definitely gonna do something like that. But yeah, I know Ja Rule happy as fuck right now.
I think 50 would beat Ja Rule. Fat Joe got a catalog though.
Fat Joe got a catalog. Yeah,
all the way back to like 94 or some shit like
Flo
that.
Flo Joe, another year.
92.
Pun got shit like Fat Joe got shit. And he's got shit new. You know what I mean? Fucking him and Remy
Lean
and all that.
Back
yeah,
and
like,
Make It Rain.
And all the fucking, like Fat Joe got a crazy He got crazy ass catalog. It's gonna be hard to go up against.
I think they both gonna play a song that diss 50 on that joint though, because they both
don't like 50.
No, Fat Joe squashed it with 50.
He did,
but 50 don't like Ja Rule.
50 really despised Ja Rule. Yeah. 50, you know he gonna have some shit to
it's
say.
It's just something about him. He just don't say. That every time he see his face, he just wanna fucking choke that nigga.
But the crazy thing is, he made fun of Ja Rule, but then fucking stole his style. That was the craziest shit ever. Like, he clowned Ja Rule for singing on the track, and then 50 came out, did the same thing. Like, that was the funny shit.
He just
about
flipped
that.
It and did it a different way. He did it. He did more hood songs.
But
it's just his material was harder. It wasn't like, I'm red, the way you walk, the way you talk. He wasn't
that
doing
song
that
was
shit.
Only hot because J Lo was on. That's the only reason niggas watched
that
video.
That shit was only hot because niggas wanted to see J Lo. And that's when the videos
the video
heavy.
Yeah, niggas wasn't listening to that, you know what I'm saying? Wasn't listening to that, Joe.
But yeah, fucking
but yeah, they
I don't know who you got in Fat Joe and Ja Rule, cause honestly,
yeah, Fat Joe got
it's gonna remind you of a lot of shit that Ja Rule got. But I probably, if you could play some shit like both of these songs, unless it's one of the like singier songs, I'm probably gonna know Fat Joe verse a little more than
Fat Joe got.
Now, the singier ones, I probably know, but I don't really like them like that. It's just like they annoy me a little bit. So, how on the radio they keep playing shit over and over
so
again.
You kind of fucking...
It's like that.
Right, real shit. That is how that shit is. Because, I mean...
You know it, even if you don't like it.
Right, even if you don't like it, you know all the motherfucking words because they played that shit 50-11 times.
50-11.
But, motherfucking Fat Joe, he gonna win that joint. Because, like you said, his catalog crazy. He got shit from the 90s, late 90s, early
2000s,
2019, 2020. Like, he got fucking...
And it's all about the lineup. So, all right. So, say if they go street or say if they go female records. Who do you think got the advantage?
Fat Joe still going. Even though Ja Rule do got some bangers on the female John. On the female tip, he do got some bangers. But no, Fat Joe still going to kill him. Because I can't think of the Jones now, but Fat Joe got some Jones with J-Lo and all like. He got some shit in his bag. You know what I mean? Like, he got some shit in his bag. So I'm definitely going to take
this bitch with
Joe
to
Don.
I keep thinking of that shit the whole time. You know what I mean? I keep thinking of that.
Make It Rain, all them Jones. Yeah, so.
He had a run. Him and Khaled, too.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, damn, I forgot about that. Yeah, so Fat Joe definitely.
And lyrical content, like, I never thought of Ja Rule as, like, lyrical.
Nobody ever thought
lyrical.
Of Ja Rule.
So I'm trying to, like, while we sitting here, like, talking, as you can see me thinking and looking, I'm like, I'm trying to think of any verse of Ja Rule's that I felt like was, like,
he killed
that nigga. He gonna kill. Yo, he killed that joint. Like, it was whole like songs where you was like, the songs is alright, but it was nothing where you was like, yo, I gotta hear that shit again.
Yeah, nah, cause even on that New York track, like, he just better play Kiss part.
Well, he on the hook. Right, he on the hook. Right. So you hear him jive through the whole song.
Like, yeah, cause he was the worst on that fucking song. Like, that's
I don't
crazy.
Remember what he said.
Exactly.
That's not nothing with me, because I don't remember a lot of songs. I remember the name of songs. I remember the highlights of songs. Yeah. I remember the hooks of songs. I even remember the ad-libs. But it's just something about the verses that it just don't resonate. If it don't resonate with me, I'm just not going to remember that shit.
Yeah, no. No, I mean, but I know that's what's up for Ja, because his stream's about to go the fuck up after this fucking verses. Yeah. So, I know he happy as shit.
Fat Joe, too.
He don't even give a fuck. Yeah,
Fat Joe, too, because he got his show, and he don't talk about his rap that much. Yeah. So now when people come on, they're going to be like,
I forgot you did that joint with such, with Khaled and all. Yeah, I mean, that shit going to be...
He had a couple eras because he was in with Lil Wayne.
That's what I'm saying.
Was in with Khaled. With Khaled era, he had his own era. Then he had the pun
era. And then he bought pun out.
He had the pun era. He had
him and Remy Ma had the new
Remy
shit.
And Ma era.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, Fat Joe got bangers.
Lean back.
Man.
Yeah.
He got bangers. Like
And he had the Diss and 50 era. That was a different era.
And he had the Diss and 50 era.
And some of them joints was hot.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna hold you. But we all wanted to see Ja Rule 50. You know what I mean?
Right,
but that we know that's not gonna happen.
Ain't gonna happen. Because it would have been a fight or something. Something would have happened. It would have been a real versus out there.
You know what I'm saying?
Celebrity
fight
death match, that's nigga. What it celebrity death match.
That was that shit.
celebrity death match.
Yo, I forgot all about that shit. Yo, bring that shit back.
Right, yeah, yo, bring that
shit
if
back.
We won our fucking
yo,
check.
If they brought celebrity death match back, bro, with all the new niggas now,
yo,
that's really
be
beefing.
With fucking Kanye and Drake in a celebrity death match.
Yeah.
Yo,
that would have been on the same week.
Yo,
that
would have
been on the same week.
Fire.
Yeah. Fucking Biden versus Trump and all that shit.
Yeah. Yo, that'd have been fire.
Yeah.
Yo, come. Yo,
no.
We need a check.
Biden versus who he run against first? Hillary. Biden versus Hillary would
have
fought. And then Biden would have won, and then it would have been Biden versus Trump.
Yo, that'd have been, they'd have had Trump versus Bernie Sanders and shit.
Fucking
yo,
Obama would have been his corner man and shit. Yo, bring that shit back.
Bring back Celebrity Deathmatch and Buck Bandit Podcast.
Let us do
royalties.
The side commentating on that motherfucking real shit.
You already know, yo, that's live.
He's fucking her up. You know what I'm saying? I'm ready.
He said, I'm ready.
You know what I mean?
Yo, yeah, that's a good joint, though.
But
that's
I think what's that a top? Well, I don't know if it's a top. What you think? Fat Joe got it?
Oh yeah, Fat Joe got it by far, for sure.
By far? Like, I don't know by far.
He said by far.
Cause
Fat Joe got it.
Neither one of them is lyrical. It's just that
that's true.
Fat Joe versus be better than his.
Fat Joe versus hit harder, right? Yeah, I mean he got them rememberable lines that you can be like, Ja Rule has no rememberable lines that I can.
Depends on the lineup. Once again, because if he picked those certain joints, Fat Joe is going to have to match him. So it probably depends on who go first. If Ja Rule
go first,
and he play,
I think Ja
Rule. You know what I mean?
If he play clap back, he automatically lost.
No,
I better not hit
no
fucking
about
clap
that.
Back.
You know he's not going to play that bullshit, dog. He's not going to play. I hope he not.
No, because that joint was coming
that
minute.
I hope he ain't going to do it. But no.
Straight up.
He ain't going to do that, but... If Ja Rule go first and he set the tempo and he start off on that, I think he could get it. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know. I got an edge towards Fat Joe too, though.
Yeah, I got an edge towards Fat Joe.
I wanted to give it to Ja. I wanted
Joe
to try
Don.
To. I don't know.
But Ja Rule definitely got some shit. Like don't sleep on Ja Rule. He got some shit.
And he more performance. Like he more rowdy. Yeah. You know what? I'm going with Ja. Fuck it.
He said, I'm going
fuck
with Ja.
It.
You heard it here first.
I'm going with Ja. You know what I mean? Holla, holla. Oh, my nigga.
That was that shit.
Dollars,
that
is murder.
He might play the drum with, when he was on the drum. Can I get a,
so
you know what I mean?
He was on that.
He killed that verse.
Okay, yeah.
Like,
so don't try to take back your pick. Don't try to
like
remember shit with Hole
like
on it.
He got some shit to tuck, but no, he ain't fucking with Flo Jo. You know what I mean? Joe the Don.
We'll see. You know what I mean? Because I had to think about it, I remember what Kiss did to Cam and him. Some of Cam and him songs was more popping.
Yeah.
And they were actual songs.
Right.
But Kiss and them are performers.
Yeah.
So if Ja Rule get on there and perform, he been better shape than Fat Joe.
That definitely could change the game.
You know what I'm saying? And his shit was more about energy. Yeah. So if he come in there, you know what I mean, tie his shit up, get in the old rule shit, take off his shirt, it's Murdo.
The bandana
when he was the mixture between DMX and Tupac. You know what I mean?
Oh, a little X-Pac and
shit. A little bit, just a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Oh, if he do that, yeah, I can see Ja Rule.
I definitely think it's gonna be a good show, though. Definitely think.
And they got it tied with Kissing Them did, so I feel like they gonna do it in the same arena, but they might bring people out.
Yeah. Now if they do that, Ja might. But I don't know, cause if Fat Joe bring Remy out and all, yeah, dog, you chill, you tripping. Fat Joe bring Remy out and they do like them three joints they did over what the past 3-4 years when Remy first came home. Yeah, it's gonna be tough for Ja Rule. Cause they had some bangers when Remy came home. You know what I mean?
I was in the shop yesterday and shit.
Yeah.
We had to talk about verses and I had to ask niggas, so I'ma ask you. Cause what? It ended up turning into a good ass a topic. Like niggas, what? We was really like talking about that shit for like an hour or two. Like who do you think will win out of a versus battle between Birdman and Diddy?
Ooh, that's the real versus we need to see. Cause both of them got crazy catalog, at least 20 plus years worth of catalog.
And it's like,
damn,
since they CEOs,
tough.
They can put shit they produce. Right, they don't got to be shit they... So, or they split
that,
it up.
And they could both bring out the shits where they was only talking on the jaw. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, so yeah, that'd be tough,
and they can
bro.
Split it up where they can do like...
I think...
10 joints of they verses and 10 of joints they produce, period.
I think Diddy would get it just because he got big.
What?
Just because he got big. Just because he got big.
So you going to take big over Nicki, Drake, and motherfucking
Guaranteed,
Wayne?
Guaranteed. He played one of the
Nicki, Drake, and Wayne.
He played 4 big tracks. That's better than 20 of their tracks.
So if he come on tripping. Playing like Call Me On My Cell Phone or some shit like that, or fucking...
Yo, if he come and play something from Ready to Die, from
bro,
Life After Death, from The Victory...
I said Call Me On My Cell Phone, but it's so many. I was about to go down the list. But
that'd be a good joint, though. That's the real fucking.
That's what I'm saying.
See right there, because that's
now,
a good joint. All right,
so all right, we're gonna start from the first half portion. When it comes down to just their verses on stuff for the first 10,
for their verses,
who you think going to win?
I'm a Diddy fan from the rip, but Birdman got better shit that he was rapping on than Diddy. I admit that, but I'm a Diddy
so
fan.
You think,
So you think
Birdman versus was better than Puff versus?
I don't think they was better than
Puff. You know some of
when Big was alive, because when Big was writing for Puff, Puff had hotter verses.
And around the time
but
Jada
no.
was writing for him.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
And Mace was writing
right,
for him.
Right, I was just reading. Everybody came as a collective to write for Puff. Like, that's
no,
why
some niggas
cheating,
ain't
like
to work with each other.
You know what I mean?
So when Kiss was
like,
writing for him.
Like, Rob was writing for him, man. But like,
everybody. Like, Kiss said that Diddy, he used to come in, have his verse, and Diddy take that and tell him to write another one, and that'd be Diddy verse.
Oh, that's so, like, your hot, bro. Let me get that joint.
Yeah, write another joint.
Yo, yeah, that's what I'm saying, but. Yeah, Birdman, dog. I can't lie.
Who you going to give it to?
What happened to that boy?
That's what I was saying.
Birdman got some bangers, bro. Like, I can't lie. Birdman.
Yo.
Above
gonna try hate. The only line he kept saying was, "Beef, I don't discuss. Water out of line, water gonna get his head bust." I was like, "Yo, that's hot though."
I was gonna say at that time that was a flame, right? That was a fucking fire ass bar. But yeah, I don't know, cause Cash Money, fuck that run. That I need a hot girl. Like he could bring out
you
all.
You talking about
joints.
The old run? He's yeah. still on a
he's
run
still
with
on a
Drake
run.
And Nicki and Wayne.
He could fucking bring out the joint with Young Thug because he
what
was
about
talking
Young
at
Thug?
The end of that song. You know what I mean? He was talking at the end of Young Thug.
He know he produced it. That could be part
that's
of the
I'm
other
saying.
10.
Like,
so if he could.
Yeah, that's right,
out of
joint.
Out of 10, he could take 3 from Nicki, 3 from Wayne, 3 from Drake. Uh-huh. No, 2 from Nicki, 2 from Young Thug. Three from Wayne, three from Drake.
Yeah.
All right. What 10 is Diddy going to have?
What? Because
you said four big
ones. He going to have fucking so two from Mace, fucking Ben, Ren, Red. Now, yeah, he going to have all these crazy out of joints, the new, dog.
Over the,
oh, the new shit? I don't
What in the lineup of Birdman shit is that going to be? Out of Drake?
Yeah, I don't know.
The Ben Around the World vibe to now?
Yeah, they ain't going to. But he could, more money, more problems.
And,
fucking all about the Benjamins.
But
like,
only if Mace come out. If Mace come out,
shit,
then maybe.
Bro.
But like, listen, all right, let's put it like this. Let's put it like this. All right, say Mace do come out. Say Lil Kim. Wait, no. Uh-huh. We talk. All this is hypothetical. Because there ain't nobody going right. to do that battle. But if yeah, they was, and it's interesting.
That is interesting.
All right, say they bring out motherfuckers. Uh-huh. We going to keep going. See, say they bring out motherfuckers, right? And now. All right, Diddy brought out Lil' Kim, Mace. You can't bring out Biggie. So if you're playing it, everybody just going to say it. So it's not going to have
that's
the same.
That's what I'm saying. That's cheating. That's why
all right,
it's
no,
cheating.
wait. No, it's not cheating. That's don't try cheating. To fuck up the vibe. So boom. So you can bring out them. You can bring out Lil' C's. You can bring out the Locks. You can't bring out. You're not going to play the verse for every dead person when they come on a song.
Yeah, you're not,
so you're going to cut that. So bet. All right, those the people you bringing out. All right, bang. Now Birdman going to come to the table. Yeah. He going to bring out Young Thug. Mm-hmm. He gonna bring out badass Nicki. Mm-hmm. He gonna bring out fucking Tyga. He gonna bring out fucking Drake.
Tyga
got fans,
Tyga,
bro.
Stay back.
He got
no,
fans.
He do.
I'm
got
just
fans,
saying.
But no,
he gonna bring out Drake. He gonna bring out Wayne. He gonna bring out Rich Homie Quan. He gonna bring out the Hot Boys. Turk and BG gonna come back for a reunion, nigga. Hot Boy. Juvenile damn, gonna come out, nigga. Fuck you talking about Snoop. No. Snoop wasn't with him. Damn, that's no limit. Fuck. I was on the road. But you know what I'm saying? He gonna bring out them. You know what I'm saying?
Oh no, that's
so
definitely fire.
Which star power is better? Which one is gonna get more reaction? Like, when was the last time you seen Wayne, Nicki, Drake, and all them on them?
Yeah,
or Young
yeah,
Thug and
yeah,
all?
Diddy definitely gonna win that.
Come
Drake
on,
triple.
Bro.
Diddy definitely gonna
what?
Win that.
What?
Diddy definitely gonna win that jump. Yeah, I mean that's a good fucking jump.
And but, the Hot Boys.
But once Diddy, no.
And the Hot Boys.
Once Diddy bring out Loon, it's a rat. Once he bring out Loon, it's a rat.
Loon, did you see Loon lately? First of all, he not gonna come and do it. And if he do, his throat is big and his beard is big. It's not the same thing when he's the clean cut kid. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm gonna say is,
once he bring out Mario Winans
and wait, and Mace, once he bring out Mace and Mario Winans, all right. But all right,
I'm trolling now. But no,
and what's the name could bring out? What's the singer he had? T Wayne or what? Or the boy T Wayne.
T Wayne
and fucking then he had Lloyd at one point.
I don't know. He might have jerked. He might have jerked Lloyd.
He had Lloyd. So what you get it, shorty? Yo, so listen, Bird. I think Birdman will win that. So put some respect on his name, and I ain't gonna say it no more. Now, all right. Oh, this is what I wanted to say though. It's gonna be a lot of bitches in the crowd, right?
Uh huh.
So when is Diddy gonna play? When Juvenile come out and put it on Back That Ass Up.
Yeah.
What are you going to play after that?
That's going to be, no, that's tough.
What, he going to do?
What? I don't give a fuck what's going on. Once you hear taking over for the 99 and 2000, everything stops and all asses shake, nigga. Like, I don't give a fuck what. Back in the day when we heard that, taking over for the 99 and 2000, Wally time, nigga. What?
That's it. Yo, you fuck out of here, dog.
Yeah, that John definitely.
That's what I'm saying. So that was a good ass conversation. Yeah, though I feel like it could go either way, but like, I feel like
he got shit with too many.
That would be a good ass verse.
Fab, you know what I mean? I need a good to ride. Like they got, Diddy
and
got.
Then he could bring out one
bangers. That's what I'm saying.
You know what
Diddy did shit with.
He could bring
so
out Mary J. Blige.
People.
He could bring out Faith Evans.
But that's gonna be
But this is what you got to remember. All his heavy hitters are dead, bro.
That's why he gonna win.
Black Rob is dead.
That's why he gonna win.
Biggie dead.
X, like, he so did shit. So you can't
play him. X not
yes,
him.
Yes, you can. X ain't him, but I'm pretty sure they. If we
his most heavy. Crazy. You're not gonna play that versus of the most heavy hitters, and if you for do, sure you're not gonna play every last one of them. Then the half the show is gonna be played. You gonna play Biggie songs? It's a listening party now. No, this is a verses.
You just gonna
nigga.
Pay one of his. You just gonna pay a couple of his verses. You know what I mean? So you can get the upper hand. That's how no. you do it.
Maybe if you yeah. start off the whole joint with one Biggie verse. All right, bet.
Cause you gotta play
or end it all off with a Biggie verse. You know what I'm saying?
Like
cool.
he could bring the locks but, out. Like he could bring the locks back. You know what
okay,
I mean?
That's
like,
cool. But we seen them like, already.
You know what I mean? But that's me even better. You know what I mean? Bring them back. You know what I mean? Okay. Play All About the Benjamins all the way through with Big Verse. Like,
but we heard that, so it's not gonna have the same effect yeah, as it did the first time.
But then he can
no, you know what? It might because he's gonna have Lil' Kim walk out.
That's what I'm saying. Like that's that. Well, I'm bumming with the B. Like, but no, that's a good. We definitely gotta have that. But both of them niggas so rich, they ain't even gonna do that shit. But that
what
is
you mean?
That'd
it's
be
for the
fucking verses of the fucking century. That'd shit all the that they should get 2-3 hours. They should play 30-40 songs.
And the thing is,
piece.
Everybody that
that'd be a
Diddy is the only dancer that we named on that side. On the that he the only one who had energy on that side besides
Once he do
Big.
A Harlem Shake is a rat.
So all right, so he big, he fat and all that shit. Now it's not the same. Now. Birdman, no disrespect, but you out of
no
shape.
No disrespect.
But you know what I'm saying? Birdman, he never was that, but his whole squad is energy. So what you gonna do with Lil Wayne running back and forth across the joint and Nicki Minaj twerking that ass?
Lil Wayne
and,
too high
and, now. And Drake out there like,
and
then he come out, Kiki, do you love me? Are you ready?
No,
yo, come on, bro.
That ain't even Birdman joint. He had nothing to do with that.
No, he produced. It. Everything they produce. No, I'm talking about everything that comes from under their umbrella.
They
ain't produce all the shit on all them other niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But so I'm saying if we playing the battle of those CEOs, it has to be a certain amount of tracks, 10 of their actual verses. We don't give a fuck who wrote it for them. And 10 of the projects
of
the people that was produced under their umbrella.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That'd be a good job. I ain't gonna lie. I think that should have come down to like the last 2-3 tracks. You know what I mean? Like that should have been neck and neck all
They'll
the
end up saying, man, it was all for the culture. Nobody won.
Yeah.
But I feel
that'd
like,
be, that'd be a good
I feel
feeling.
Like before watching it, like pre-fight, I feel like Birdman would have it. You know, I ain't going to hold you. Like I feel like I liked all Puff shit better for the time it was in. But I feel
but
like.
When you hear it now.
Birdman, yeah, it's not the same feeling as it what is where. Well, the feeling is probably better because it's from when you was younger. But as far as the vibe, Birdman got too much of variety of vibe. Whereas though, when you pick from Puff Batch, it's all that Bad Boy era, the rap and all. Where you pick from
no
Birdman is Nicki type shit. Ain't nothing like Drake shit. Ain't nothing like Wayne shit. Yeah. Ain't nothing like Thug shit. So it's like you're gonna get so many different sonic sounds hitting you from this side. Where all this is just one vibe. It's gonna connect the older niggas to their childhood, but on this side is way more power. It's way more star power on Birdman.
Definitely a longer reign too. Like Birdman stay, even though he wasn't in the forefront, like he made sure his fucking team stayed relevant all the way up until
He made sure he stayed relevant because like, no matter who, after one person pop, he got another person to pop. After he pop, we got somebody else to pop. After he pop, we got some. So he keep his shit going. You know what I mean? Because he had a whole that whole era with Thug and fucking Rich Homie Quan, you know what I'm saying? Like,
definitely did.
That was
did
a whole. I'm like, yo, this nigga just keep recreating his brand on the other shit. Like, that's a vibe.
That's definitely a good joint, but that'd definitely be the verses of the fucking century. They do that shit. That'd be the best verses right there.
If he fucked with Ab, that would have started a different joint. He would have went back to hard.
That would have been crazy.
That would have made that would have put Rich Gang on that'd some harsh crazy. Compton Menace and Ab with a song with him. That shit would have been crazy.
Yeah.
But yeah, man,
that's
a
crazy joint.
Skirt. We was on that tizopic for a minute.
Yeah, we.
But
we
I told you I was in a barbershop talking about that shit. So anytime nigga you we in there talking about that shit for hours, you know that's like. You know what I mean? And put what y'all think at the bottom, too. You know what I mean? If y'all think that was a good versus or some other people that might be a good versus.
Right.
You know what I mean? Put that shit down below in the comments, man. Make sure you like and subscribe, too. Stop playing. You know what I'm saying?
You already know. What we getting into now? What we got?
One more before we get to the halfway mark. You know what I'm saying? But
yeah, you know what it is, the kid Buck Bandit Reno.
Boy, Buck Bandit Pig.
And we the host of Buck Bandit Podcast, man.
Right,
and if you don't know, we on season 2, man. So if you ain't check us out, man, make sure you check us out, man.
Definitely make sure you check us out, man. Definitely. On all streaming platforms, wherever you get your podcasts.
All right, sir. Watch the videos on YouTube.
Right.
You know what I mean? We talk about everything from entertainment, sports. Man, all the bullshit going down on the social media, everything.
I mean, if y'all out there doing some crazy shit, don't be doing some crazy shit, yeah. But we gonna talk about
yeah,
this
yeah.
shit.
Yeah, yeah. And definitely you can come and watch me, your boy, win 95% of the arguments too, you know, because
oh, yeah.
I always know everything,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's some bullshit. I win all the
he definitely gonna win.
Gilly, man, did you see the video where Gil... You know what I'm saying? Ran down
what
the sideline.
Do,
all right, Deion Sanders' team, Jackson State, HBCU. You know what I mean? Shout out. You know what I mean? They had a game. Gilly Wallow went to the game. He let him be assistant coaches for the game.
Uh-huh.
And I guess after a fumble or whatever, they picked it up. The refs didn't blow the whistle. They ran down, and then you look on the sideline, Gilly running with him down the sideline.
Uh-huh. They have not whistled it, so they're going to pick up. And all the way down the sideline, there's C.J. Holmes.
You know what I mean? And then when he get to the end zone, the guy hand the ball to Gilly.
Give him the ball.
Gilly used to fucking spike that shit. You know what I'm saying?
You know Gil don't give no fucks. You know he was hype and shit.
Yeah.
You seen the joint when he was in the locker room dancing with the niggas?
Yeah. He fucking explained that shit.
Yeah,
he
that
said
shit
he ain't know the young
shit.
Boy was going to give him the ball. He said he did the only thing he knew how to do.
I didn't know what happened
okay.
until I got on the plane after okay. the game. So okay. I'm on the plane after right. the game.
Uh-huh.
We've got a 15-yard penalty, which they retained the possession, and they kicked three. They made three. So okay. I went off on my team. I went off on them. We don't run down the sideline, off the sideline, from the bench. That's a penalty. We did that junk in practice. I told y'all that. And then I'm on the plane after the game.
Right,
and I'm
right,
going
right.
through my text message and all that, and I said, Gilly? That was Gilly? Hey, man, can you explain yourself, man?
He scooped the ball up. He started running. I'm telling them, come on, let's go. They told me, Gilly, stay behind the white. If you look at the video, I stayed behind the white. The whole time I'm running down the sideline, I said, come on, let's go. We got to the end zone. I turned to him. I said, yeah, youngin. He gave me the ball. I did the only thing I knew what to do, bro. I spiked
that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that but that fun. Shit love because it's a HBCU. It's bringing more attention to the school.
Right.
Yeah, it got called back, but they end up winning anyway. They got a whole lot of press from him doing
yeah.
that shit. And it's like,
still
it make other people like, yo, I would want to go to one of them schools or even just yeah. Jackson State because is it even though it's a HBCU, you know what I mean? Black stars come down there to show love. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying? They actually come to the games. They hype them up. You know what I mean? All you right. don't know what that do for people who never... You know what I mean? Like, some of them kids, to be honest, a lot of them not going to make it to the next level.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that might be the highlight of some of their lives, careers. You doing that, energizing them, and them going through with this. So that's love, man, because niggas don't do that shit.
Yeah, that's definitely love. And you got prime time as a motherfucking coach.
And you got, you
know what I mean? You
can't go wrong with prime.
You already know you can't go wrong with prime. And prime all for the culture. So you already know. He was like, yo, y'all come down, be assistant coaches. Like, that's love.
And he got two sons on the team.
You know what I mean? Like, your coach do that. Like, mm-hmm. yeah, that's love. That was a good jump. But I've definitely seen them niggas. They was in the locker room, you know what I mean? Grooving, dancing with them niggas, getting them niggas hype and shit. I'm like, yo, that's what's up.
Yeah.
They definitely putting off of HBCUs, putting my niggas on the map. Like, that's
and we need
up,
that,
man.
Bring the money back home because now
right.
it's like they seeing for years that, you know what I mean? It's not home because I didn't go to HBCU and none of that, but
right.
it's more like
shit.
Get a school, get our money to the black schools, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, get them time to fuck it up. You know
right,
I mean? Like,
right, fuck
they,
that.
Y'all been fucking it up for years. Get them time to fuck
right.
it up, you know what I mean?
Straight up. Because
I'm not
man,
even going to say everything will go to the right places, but at least
yeah.
there's opportunities, more opportunities for us,
exactly.
you know what I mean? We ain't get the fucking reparations. We ain't get the acres. You know what I mean?
We
damn sure don't need a. I don't
we,
need a motherfucking
say,
mule.
Niggas don't even need
I'm going to get a fucking
now.
Ticket for the mule
right.
at this point.
Nigga, you know nigga, I mean? Give me a fucking Rari or something. Fuck that.
Real like, shit. You know what I mean? I don't even want Rari. The Rari. Just give me the money. You know what I mean? Just like, give me the money. That's straight it. Up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was definitely a good look. That's what's up, man. Shout out to Jackson State. Shout out to Primetime. Shout out to Gil and Wallow. Yes, shout out to the whole situation. That was that was a good jump.
That was love. Good pressure. I mean, they seem to not miss nothing at all these days.
Right.
They
on it.
They be on everything, man.
Yeah. That's so, love, though.
Skirt, skirt. We gonna get to the second half, man. Cause
what we got on this second half.
You know what we got on the second half, man.
Yeah.
What we going to start off with?
Let's see.
You want to start off with the All-Star Spotlight?
All-Star Spotlight.
Me. You know what I'm saying? So this week's All-Star Spotlight is going to go to the, you know what I mean, the funny. He a producer, but he a comedian, too.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know if he ever get his dreads done over or not. You know what I mean? Because the shit look the same way. But, you know what I'm saying? It's never seemed to be super fuzzy. It's the, you know what I mean? So, obviously, something is happening there. You know what I mean? Shout out to Pat Cloud.
It's the Buck Beat It Podcast. Hey. It's the Buck Beat It Podcast. Hey.
You know what I'm saying? From All Def. You know what I mean?
You already know.
All Def Digital. He a producer. He definitely came up with the shows like Roast
producer,
Me
writer and
Black
all that.
Blast for
that's
Me and a lot of other shows he came up with that's definitely hot. You know what I'm saying?
And all them Jones and none of them Jones is fucking whack. I was mad they took the Classroom Jones away. That
I'm mad they took the Black funny. Office away.
Yeah, that Jones.
That shit was funny.
The Black Office
fuck,
was
bro.
Fucking funny as
when
shit.
When they did the Office, yo, bring that shit back.
Yeah,
the
that
Office.
Jones a good. That was a good Jones. Yeah. They was like, what the fuck do this nigga Pat be doing on his days off? Nobody knows.
That shit was fire, cuz.
Yeah, that shit was fire. You definitely know what I'm saying? Shout out to him.
But yeah, he definitely funny. He good with the roasting. I haven't heard of stand-up. I don't think he do stand-up. You know what I'm saying? But, you know what I'm saying? Everything else is solid when it comes to it. So shout out to Pat, man.
You already know.
He definitely doing his thing. He be online doing those what you call them, the review split videos and shit like that.
Oh, all right, yeah.
That shit funny too, man. So keep doing your thing, man. Shout out to you, man.
Yes, sir.
We looking forward
to
some more projects, man. We watching.
You already know. We definitely locked in. Locked and loaded.
So next I'm gonna go into this unforgettable moment.
It's unforgettable.
You yes, already sir. Know.
What's an unforgettable moment this week?
Now, I got a couple, and I think I told you one. You know what I'm saying? But I can't decide because they both so good. It's not good per se, but it's good. You know what I'm saying? So this unforgettable moment, maybe a lot of you will remember. Remember, man, I'm mad I don't got them fucking names right. But we showing the video right now where the mom was mad because the son had announced that he was going to Florida Gators or another school instead of Alabama or Tennessee, where she wanted him to go, and walked the motherfucker out.
He was like,
now I'm taking my time for the next 3 to 4 years.
Jacob, you're going to Florida. Who just got up and left there and to your right? Who got up and left?
Oh, that was my mom.
Like this on live TV.
This motherfucker. What kind of shit is this?
On live TV, she woke
the
fuck up.
Yeah, I definitely remember that shit. I was like, oh, shit. You think a mom going to support her son no matter what?
No.
Not in this
disrespect,
case.
Disrespect, nigga.
Like, what? You going to Florida Gators? These
you could tell the whole night she was like, nigga, and you're going to Alabama. That's where you know you're going. So when we get up there, don't be acting motherfucking stupid, nigga. You ain't moving across the country. You're staying here in Alabama. And
oh,
then
yeah,
he
mom.
Was like,
out.
Florida. Fuck you talking about. I'm going to the beaches.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? What you mean? To be a fucking star college football player in Florida? Do you know where all the bitches? Mom, stop
All the bitches.
You know what I'm saying? Straight if you got it, I mean, I don't think it's a hard decision. Tennessee, Alabama, Florida. Yeah, it's not really a hard decision.
I'm definitely going to Florida. Like you,
to be honest.
Yeah, so. Mom, you're just going to have to be mad at me for a minute. You'll get over it.
You know what I mean? It was years ago, but you know what I'm saying? That was an unforgettable moment. Unforgettable. You know what I mean? It happened a couple times after that. You know what I'm saying? Where I think another mom had came back after, whatever. You know what I'm saying?
She'll get over it.
They'll get over it. You know what I'm saying?
But you know, that was definitely unforgettable.
That was
right
definitely
there.
Unforgettable. That was fucked up. And let's go to this next part. You already know, bro. Things.
I never knew.
Yeah, I never knew.
I never knew.
So, there's a couple of things I never knew. And I changed it at the last minute because I thought this shit was interesting. Very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if many people know about this, and this might inspire motherfuckers to go get an actual job. You know what I mean? Now, P.
Actual job.
Do you want to know what I know?
Yeah, of course.
That I didn't know?
Of course.
But I know it, but I didn't know it.
But you know it now. Well, I don't know it.
Just think about it. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know.
Did you know if a Google employee dies, right? A Google employee. Their spouse gets paid half of their salary for the next 10 years, and their kids get paid $1,000 a month until they turn 19.
God damn. I'm about to tell somebody, go get a fucking Google job, then murk their ass.
Well, motherfuckers. Well, I guess they got to do the investigation still.
Damn, so. That's crazy. Google looking the fuck out. Shout out to Google.
Yeah, not too many people do. Now, wait a minute. Now, do this person got to die of natural causes?
Yeah, right. What's the stipulation?
Yeah, it got to be something in it. Because they're not just giving away money like that. You know what I mean?
Oh, nigga, you was in a shootout? Oh, no, nigga, we ain't paying your family shit. Hey, nigga, you was reckless out here.
I don't know the stipulations under that. But if that's a true fact, shout out to Google because
shout out to Google.
Y'all make a lot of motherfucking money off us.
Right.
And by us, I mean the people because everybody give Google money. Like,
guaranteed.
Every time you fucking open your phone, you giving Google money. Some money.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying?
Every time you try and search some shit, you just gave Google some fucking bread. That's a fact.
Another thing that
I never knew.
Never knew. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? You know the comedian Tommy Davidson?
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? From A Living Color, a whole other bunch of different projects and shit like that.
Shabang, great, bang.
Great stand-up comedian. You know what I'm saying? Well,
Tommy Davidson,
did you know that when he was a baby, he was thrown in the trash?
Oh,
like on Empire.
Like he's throwing in the trash. Losing Isaiah, nigga.
Yeah, losing Isaiah. That too. See, that damn, that plot play a lot in different black films,
right?
And fucking TV. Like, that's crazy.
That's crazy.
But he was thrown in the trash as a baby. His teachers found him.
Dang.
His mom's teachers found him in there.
Damn.
You know what I mean? Adopted him.
Yeah, so what, his mom was like 14 as a little girl or something?
Yeah.
Well, she had to be in
school.
She was younger. It's her teacher.
And the teachers adopted him, and he grew up not even knowing he was black. Like, he didn't even know.
Oh,
like,
shit.
He didn't know till he got into a black neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? Or got in a black neighborhood. They was saying, you know what I mean, shit to him about his family. Then went to a white neighborhood and they was calling him nigger. He ain't know what that was.
Hey, man, what the
you
fuck
know
that
what I'm
mean?
Saying? Like, you
so
know what I mean?
The fuck?
So
that nigga real life losing Isaiah that made it big.
Yeah, made it big, man. On some real shit. But that's one thing I never knew. Like, that shows like through comedy and through, you know what I mean, people shit, they really went through shit to get to where they at. And just cause you don't see people's scars don't mean they ain't got some.
That's a
you know
fact.
What I mean? You never know what somebody going through to even prep, to even bring shit like music or comedy or fucking, you know what I mean, even a podcast to you and shit. Like,
rare
people
shit.
Go through shit every day, but it's the dedication and the commitment to wanting something
rare
better
shit.
That keep them coming back you know what I mean, and doing more and bringing it to you. So,
yeah, that, you know what I mean? I ain't know that, though. That nigga, damn, that's crazy. I know that they salty as shit. You done threw the gold away. You done, that's crazy. But, yeah, that's a bad joint. That nigga real life losing Isaiah. God damn.
Yeah.
Losing Tommy Davidson.
Yeah.
Damn.
And he the bag.
You already know. Threw the gold away. You dumb as shit for that. I know you mad as shit about that one. So, Saudi McNaughty.
You already know.
Saudi McNaughty. But, yeah, shout out to him for overcoming that. Like, straight up. Like,
for sure. And doing it in a big way.
Yeah. Yeah, shout out to that. Damn, I definitely ain't know that, though.
And we about to wrap up the show, but before we do...
You already know what we getting
we gotta into. We got to give them something to watch. We can't just be...
Something to watch.
You know what I mean? We just can't be stingy with the knowledge and the shit that we got or, you know, the type of shit we look at. Sometimes people want to know what we watching, so, you know what I mean? You tell them what you watching first, you know what I'm saying? And then I'm going to come in, I'm going to let them know what I'm doing, you know what I mean?
Well... One thing I'm always watching, I'm always tuned in to EYL. If y'all ain't tuned in to them, definitely check out EYL, Earn Your Leisure. But specifically, episode 150, they had Ryan Leslie and Hill Harper on there. That joint was a banger. They just talk about a whole bunch of shit that motherfuckers need to tap into. They talking about investing. They talking about just shit how... the world is going and how everything turned into this technology and how we could take advantage of this shit. So if you trying to get a bag, you trying to earn your leisure for real, check out EYL episode 150. You can check it out on YouTube or wherever you listen to your podcast at. But watch that joint. I like the visuals. So make sure y'all check that joint. I'll watch that joint on the tube.
What is it called again?
EYL, Earn Your Leisure. But specifically episode 150. Check out that joint.
Okay.
That joint popping.
Okay.
So what you tune into? What you watching? What's on your watch list this week? You know what I mean?
Honestly, I've been watching a lot of shit because there's been a lot of shit going on, especially with football. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of young giants coming in the game now. This year has been the most black quarterbacks to start a season in the history of the NFL.
Damn.
You know what I mean?
Moving up.
You know what I mean? I remember at a time where they said, you know what I mean?
Niggas like couldn't play
quarterback. Like nigga like Michael Vick was bad. And now everybody trying to get the next, you know what I mean, Michael Vick. You know what I mean?
Real shit. Trying to get the upgraded Michael Vick. You know what I mean?
I've been watching a lot of shit, though. I'm trying to remember the name. Oh, yeah. So if you haven't checked it out, you know what I'm saying? Check out the Scarface and Willie D podcast.
Ooh, that sounds like that's fire.
Yeah, like I seen Scarface in a different light. I never seen him before. Yeah, I mean, usually when you see him, it's through the music and shit like that. And they got real good conversations. I can name certain podcasts, but I'd rather you just check it out. Look at the guests and see for yourself. But they got good conversation, man. They keep it real. You know what I mean? And it's coming from like OGs that, you know what I mean, your fucking parents probably grew up listening to too. On top of our era.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't like it's not no lame OGs. It's like it's Scarface, nigga.
Right,
like,
I was just trying to
say. My mom playing tricks on me, like Willie D. You know what I'm saying? So definitely Scarface, you get your chance.
That's
check like that out, banger. Man.
That definitely sound like a banger.
It's called Ghetto Boys.
Ghetto Boys. That's only right. It's only right they call it Ghetto Boys.
So check out the Ghetto Boys podcast, man.
That's dope. Definitely.
You already know. So yes, this has been another good show, man.
Great show. You know what I mean?
Yeah, there's a lot of things we could be getting into, man. I feel like we could go longer, but you know, we gonna cut it thin. Like wheat thins, you feel me?
But we're going to be back here next week. Y'all. You already
next
know.
Week.
You know what I mean?
Keep showing the love. Shout out to everybody that's liking the podcast, that's watching, that's staying tuned. Shout out to the listeners.
Definitely.
You know what I mean?
Out
shout
y'all.
Out to the viewers. Make sure you
definitely
subscribe.
Subscribe. You know what I mean?
You already know, man. It's the Buck Bane the Podcast, episode 32. What it do?
Buck. Yes, sir. Buck.
Wind it back. Time for nothing. Time for front. Time for cuffing. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Time for love. no time for this. Waste time on that. Ooh, time on yo. Rewind it back.
Ain't got time for nothing. Ain't got time for friends. Ain't got time for comfort. But I can make time for loving. Ain't got time for this. Can't waste time on that. Can't waste time on you. Cause I can't rewind the back. Ain't got time for nothing. Ain't got time for friends. Ain't got time for comfort. But I can make time for loving. Ain't got time for this. Can't waste time on that. Can't waste time on you. Cause I can't rewind it back.
I ain't got time for nothing. Act like you mean more than my grind or something. Act like you been on my mind or something. Yeah, little bitch, you a dime a dozen. She